All right, so I was in the mood to kind of like just mellow out and listen to some records and, you know, drink, sip on some wine or whatever. And so the record that I had this one record I was looking for in particular, this the George Benson record, and it wasn't in this crate. It wasn't in this pile that I thought it was in or whatever, so I had to go and look for it. So in the midst of me looking for this one record, I came across one of my mother's 45s, and this 45 was actually, my mother had a group when she was a teenager. When she was young, she had this group called Sisters of Righteousness, and it was herself, her younger sister Denise, and their cousin Roberta Du Bois. And So I came across this record. And actually, if you look on the record, there's a picture of James Brown's face. And it says, like, James Brown Productions or something like that, towards the left side of the 45. And I'm going to talk about that in a second. But anyways, you know, looking at this record, it just kind of made me think about kind of my first musical influence, which was, you know, most likely had to have been my mother. Because, you know, when I was growing up, she was always a working musician. So she, you know, she played with the Cincinnati Symphony Orchestra or different instrumentalists in the city or whatever. And Cincinnati Ballet Company had, like, a symphony or orchestra or whatever. And, but she was also a Cincinnati public school teacher. So, you know, always music going on in the house or whatever. And it just made me want to you know, do iCartoons diary episode where I talk about her. So I talked to my mom about it. Her name is Geneva Wood, by the way. So I talked to my mom about it, and she was like, oh, that's fine, but I don't want to be on camera. So I was like, all right. So I got her audio, so whenever she talks, I haven't edited the video yet. So whenever she talks, I don't know, I might have her you might see pictures of her, like, playing the piano with her, like, short, stubby fingers with, like, a Steinway & Sons emblem in the back, or a picture of her, I don't know. But she did not want to be on camera. Her sister, Denise, I asked her if she would, you know, if she could lend some information. She was, like, fine. And so I went over to her house, and then she didn't mind being on camera at all, so thank you, Denise. But, you know, I went over there, and, you know, she told me a lot of things and showed me a lot of things as well. So that was cool. Starting off with my, you know, early things with my mom, you know, I've always talked to her all my life about her early beginnings. And, you know, just real quick, she started playing the piano when she was 3. She's from this part of town in Cincinnati called East End, which at that time was a predominantly black, lower middle class neighborhood or whatever. So, you know, she always told me about how they didn't have a lot of money. You know, there were a whole lot of, you know, nights, you know, where they, you know, didn't have any food. But music was the most consistent thing in her life. So that was the thing that she could always kind of depend on or whatnot. Now, I asked her actually to go, if we could go look at her old house and I could take some shots with my camera. And we got there. And in the midst of doing that, this guy was renovating the house, and he let us come in, and I probably saved majority of that footage for, like, something else. But, you know, my mother was able to show me where the piano was, you know, situated in the house, and told me how she would close all the doors in the house and just be up, you know, in the wee hours of the morning just playing the piano. And so that was pretty cool. You know, with her high school, when they were there, they did recitals and things, and she actually had an audio recording of her recital that she did when she was 14. Check with the James Brown thing real quick. Kind of a pre thing, you know, my mother, like I said, my mother, her sister, and their cousin were this group called Sisters of Righteous. And there was a time period when James Brown did a lot of recordings at this record company called King's Records in Cincinnati. in this part of town called Evanston, which is actually, it's a couple blocks from my high school on the hills. And, but, you know, they were backup singers. They had their own group, but they were backup singers for him. So, you know, kind of like, you know, some of his popular songs, like I'm Black and I'm Proud and The Big Payback and things like that. They were on those records. So, my favorite record, that favorite song they were on was The Big Payback. So, like I said, I haven't edited this video yet, but that'll probably be playing like the majority of the time. And I'm probably going to start playing it right about now.
Hey! Actually, I was about, I was in my early teens. I always had a little youth choir at church. And it just so happened that a couple of the arrangers from King Recording Company came to our church one morning and they heard the singing group.
Gene Red discovered us when we were singing at the church choir at El Bethel Baptist Church. And Gene had us come over to King. And that's when, you know, we started singing and James heard us. And James decided he wanted our group. So he took our group from Gene Red, and of course he had James Brown Productions then. So he decided to sign us under contract with James Brown Productions. So that was very, very memorable also, when his manager, Bud Hopgood, was the first one that told us that James had now taken over our group from Gene Red. We didn't have a name at that time. And that's when James told us that our name was the Sisters of Righteous. Mm-hmm. And and that was really memorable because, you know, at that time, you know, I was a senior in high school. Me and my cousin and my sister, she was at CCM at UC, classical music. So we were really into education. So, you know, we politely told James, well, don't you mean you want us to be called the Sisters of Righteousness? And he said, no, the Sisters of Righteous. So we said, okay. So that's how we got our name, the Sisters of Righteous. And I'll never forget that.